The slope of a line is the ratio of the vertical change to the horizontal change, often written as the rise over run, which measures the change in y with respect to the change of x. So if we're given two points on a line, we can determine the slope of that line by determining the change in the y-coordinates with respect to the change in the x-coordinates. And notice how we use these subscripts to keep track of the y-coordinates and x-coordinates. So if we call these the ones and these the twos, this would be x sub 1, this would be y sub 1, and this would be x sub 2, and this would be y sub 2. So using our formula, the slope of this line is going to be equal to y sub 2 minus y sub 1, that's 4 minus 10, over x sub 2 minus x sub 1, that would be 7 minus 5. So we'd have negative 6 all over positive 2. Well, negative 6 divided by positive 2 is equal to negative 3. To get a better understanding of what this means, let's take a look at the line passing through these two points. Remember, we said the slope of this line was equal to negative 3. Well, if we move from this point to this point, notice how the vertical change would be down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 units, and right 2 units. So we'd have a vertical change of negative 6 and a horizontal change of positive 2. And notice the ratio would be negative 6 to positive 2, which does simplify to negative 3, which is our slope. And then also notice, because the slope is negative, as we move along the line from left to right, the line is slanted downward. And that's always true if the slope is negative. Let's go ahead and take a look at a second example. Again, we have two points on the line. So let's go ahead and call these the ones, x sub 1, y sub 1, and x sub 2, y sub 2. And now we can apply the slope formula. So y2 minus y sub 1, that'd be 5 minus negative 1, all over x sub 2 minus x sub 1, that's 13 minus 4. Well, this becomes 5 plus 1, that would be 6. And 13 minus 4 is 9, so we have 6 ninths. But there's a common factor of 3 here. So this simplifies to 2/3, which is the slope of the line passing through these two points. Let's take a look at this line as well. Again, we said the slope was equal to 2/3. Let's see what the ratio of the vertical change to horizontal change would be moving from this point to this point. Notice how we'd have to go up 6 units, and then right 9 units. So from this point to this point, the vertical change was positive 6 because we went up 6, and the horizontal change was positive 9 because we went right 9 units. So the ratio of the vertical change to horizontal change would be 6 ninths, which again does simplify to 2/3, which we found as the slope using our formula. And again, notice how the slope was positive, so as we move along the line from left to right, this line is slanted upward, which again is always true if the slope is positive. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.